I know it's been a while since I've done a video entry for you. So today I'm going to show you guys an interview I recorded with Petaluma artist Michael Garlington. He recently collaborated with Laura Kimpton at Burning Man, published a book. It's called Portraits from Inside the Belly of the Whale. I know it's backwards, but you get the idea. And I looked through this book and I was just amazed at his subject matter. I mean, you have a combination of really distorted kind of portraits and a bit of surrealism as well, but mostly I was just like really drawn to the sort of 50s Leave It to Beaver references, Stanley Kubrick. So here's my interview with Michael Garlington. I hope you guys enjoy it and I'll see you soon.
My sweet love. Gotta get in the No, you never look at the camera. That's one thing.
So, tell me a bit about your childhood and personal experiences, and, you know, those experiences that sort of led you to your aesthetic.
Petaluma. Oh my god. Petaluma led me to this aesthetic. There's something special about this town. I just, on a bright note, I think it just, you know, people come from San Francisco or Marin County to this town to come and change it, and it seems to change them.
So, you're a photographer. Did you always want to be a photographer when you were growing up?
No, not at all. But I always knew that I wanted to do art. When it came time to actually start playing around with the camera, which I started playing around with a 4x5 camera with this large format film, I really knew how to make a beautiful, emotional print. And I always loved to work with people. So, I mean, it seemed to be the right way to express myself.
Where do you get sort of your inspiration for a lot of the imagery that moves through the narrative of your work? Because it seems like there's a certain theme of, you know, kind of dark, like you said earlier, and then also it's like a lighthearted kind of, you know, vibe about it as well.
Well, yeah, I mean, I think I said earlier, I mean, you can make your art as pretentious as possible, but you really need to always have a sense of humor about it, you know? I was in New York City, again, before I had taken any of the photos that I had started taking. And I went to the Guggenheim, and up on the second floor, I had seen Joel Peter Wickham. And he has, he has some very dark imagery with cadavers. And when I left that gallery, I was moved. I was totally moved. Art had finally moved me. I was moved to disgust, and I was moved to tears. Got back from New York on that trip, I started taking portraits of my friend against a big backdrop. But every weekend, I would go out like a fucking hunter. Need to find that scenario, that person. People always ask me, how do you get your models? And it's no more than just asking, taking that chance.
Let's talk about Burning Man.
Burning Man.
So how did you go about getting, you know, this really amazing opportunity to get involved and get your work out?
Well, I mean, it was really Laura Kimpton, the driving force behind this project. So she came to me. And we've been working together for a few years, and to decorate one of her words, which was ego. She has her vision, and then she basically lets you go. I just started to bring different vignettes and concepts. It's been so great. And as I said earlier, I mean, it's like I finally felt, I looked up to these towering letters as I worked. Day after day, I was like, I'm finally utilized to my full potential.
What's the actual concept behind ego? You were talking earlier about kind of these vignettes and little sort of frames that tell these stories. Do you want to tell me more about that?
I think the word ego being Laura's concept has a lot, she has a lot of opinion and background on what it means to her. To me, I find it to be a word that can mean a lot to everybody. So it's what gets us up, it's what dresses us. Can I get a dragon eye?
The piece altogether stands 20 feet tall.
Yes.
How long did it take you and your team to really see this come to fruition?
We've been doing this for 7 months now. We have about 150 molds. So you pour all those, wire each one first, pour them, pull them out, wire again. I mean.
So a lot of the physical vocabulary of your piece involves a lot of religious imagery and, you know, a lot of Americana sort of iconic symbols with the football players and the cheerleaders and pageant queen. Would you consider this piece to be sort of your own point of view?
I think a lot of that is like primary process. I think a lot of it is things that I tend to gravitate towards.
Okay.
My visual stimuli. I do love Americana. It could be evocative to me, and if it is evocative to me, it will be evocative to other people. This is going to burn down in a few weeks time. So we're going to see pictures on the internet forever and YouTube videos. And we're going to basically see a large gilded ego in the sun. Those are going to be most of the pictures. And then a burning ego in the night.
So you spent about 7 months on this piece. How do you feel about taking it apart, putting it back up together in Reno, setting it on fire and burning it to the ground and essentially destroying what you've worked so hard to conceive?
I love it. I don't feel like I'm ever going to lose the ego. I feel so privileged to be able to have worked on it, because for me, it's just building this art. It was so fun. So in the end, I feel great about the whole movement, building it here, coming from nothing, from scraps.
So after Burning Man, would you consider doing anything like this again?
Absolutely.
Do you have any future projects that you're currently working on that you'd like to talk about?
Next is the 111 Minute Show in San Francisco. And it's going to be all new photography. Basically, what I'm working on now are these large picture frames that you can almost walk into. So the photograph is the centerpiece. And around you, you almost feel like you are enveloped by the scene. So that's coming up in April 2013.
So do you have any advice for young people who are trying to expose their work and find their way to sort of fit in the niche that is the San Francisco art community?
It's not easy. I mean, the art world is incredibly cruel. So you have to have a thick skin. If you love this, then you're going to do this. Keep going. Do not quit. And whatever that means, I mean, whatever your passion is, you know, you celebrate art and culture.
Thank you for your time.
Thanks so much. Yeah, I appreciate it.
The glow of blue.